Back at it again on a beautiful summer morning. We are going to build up the 1926 Mack AC Bulldog log hauler by Atlantis. This is, of course, a reissue of the old Monogram kit. It is a beauty, a nice big kit. It's got 136 parts, comes out to almost 11 inches long. It's even got the logs in here and everything. So we're going to take a look what's inside the box. Atlantis is reissuing these. These come out in a couple versions. One's a tanker version. They've got another version. And hopefully, if this one is a success for the reissue, they will produce more. Check out that vintage box art on there. Absolutely gorgeous. Let's take a look at all the pieces and parts inside the box. First up, the logs. And you can see the size of those. My big hands across there. We've got a nice texture on the side. They're done up in halves. We've got wedges and supports for the bed. The wedges make sure the logs don't roll off the side. And even the wedges are made as if they cut a chunk out of each log or other logs, split a wedge off of them, which would be extremely accurate, and you have three of them there to build up. We've got a set of six rubbery style tires. Check out the tread pattern on those, that diamond tread. Jay Leno has shown trucks like this, very similar. I don't know if they were Macs, but they were extremely similar with the solid rubber tires. And over 100 years later, Jay Leno's still running on those solid rubber tires. We've got glass here. If you choose to use the windshield, you do have options. You've got your glass, you've got your headlights, and some small side or spotlights there. We've got a little bag of chain for wrapping the logs up. Nice size chain. It is real metal. You can feel it's nice and heavy. We've got a nice set of decals. We've got some pinstriping for the side of the cab. If you want to go all deluxe on it, you can see it right there. It says Columbia Lumber Company, same as these two logos. We've got the Big Oak Timber Company from Allentown, Pennsylvania, and Big Oak logos. We've got old license plates from 1926. We got two fours there for the truck number. We got two nines or sixes if you want to use them. We've got other license plates, and we've got Mack logos. And from my experience, Atlantis decals are extremely thin and durable and should lay down pretty nice. Now let's take a look at what's in the plastic, and I'll be right back. All right, first up, I will show off the black plastic. It is molded in two colors of styrene. We got that nice, looks like a four-cylinder engine. It's even got plugs on the top. We've got a floorboard in black. We've got axles, springs, chain drive. Isn't that a cool-looking chain drive on there? Frame cross members, all small linkages. We got our lights here, molded in black. Little jacks or lanterns on there, pedals. All nice looking equipment, nice thick axle there, so we're not going to have any sagging or breakage. On this tree, we've got our frame with the other springs, so we should be able to mount everything pretty straight since half the springs and the front springs are attached. We've got our transmission, part of the gear drive back there, steering wheel with all its like mixture throttle on there, the nice bench seat, and check it out, it's even textured. So we've got all kinds of components on here. We got tow hooks, more springs, small levers, looks like an exhaust manifold, intake system possibly on there. All neat stuff, a lot of cool stuff in black. You really might not even have to paint the model if you wanted to do it nice and basic. On the red, we've got the fenders, firewall, what looks like the seat possibly, the bottom of the seat. We got those nice big wheels, and this is 1/24th scale. We got the firewall there. We've got maybe a radiator or cab support, back of the hood possibly. You have options to build this with an open cab, with a windshield, or even a half cab, so no roof or anything, just the body itself and the fenders and the hood. You do have that option when you put yours together. On this one, we've got a nice one-piece hood, which will help quite a bit. We've got our cab sides, which actually have little rivets on there. Cab roof, looks like top of the radiator or fuel tank. Drive wheels in the back, it is duals in the back. Back of the cab. Windshield. that is has a wood texture to it, like the real thing. And then the final parts tree is the bed. The flatbed has wood texture and graining with spaces in between. It is molded in red, so you probably, if you want to do a painted bed, I'm sure they did plenty of them. We've got our side placards for the bed, and we've got our steel support system for that bed. That is all the parts that are in the box. Like I said, 136 of them. I'm going to get to gluing mine version together, and I'll be right back.
Thank you. Thank you.
After an extensive build session, and not really difficult, just extensive time consuming, we are where we are here. Now I've got a bunch of parts laying over to the side. Those are still on their trees, just divided in the way I want to paint them. We're only going to go over stuff that I actually had to assemble because there's a good amount of it, and there's a ton of extra parts on the side that will be attached later, like the bed and stuff, but that did not require any assembly. We've got all three logs together. I didn't do that on the assembly camera. That's just gluing each half together. They line up easily with pins, and then we will get some paint. I do have them clamped for a little while just to make sure the seams are as small as possible. I am not going to go and smooth those out and then rescribe in the log. They're going to look fine. We're going to get them on the truck and they're going to look lovely. So you got those nice three pieces there. On this tree, we've got the very front piece of the frame and the front bumper, should you want to attach the front bumper and make like a little wood bumper for it. I do, so I did have to open up the holes on the back of that piece with just a small drill or an X-Acto knife, glue that together. We'll get that painted. The reason that can't be attached to the frame right now, we would normally do that, is because the engine must slide in from the front, and if this is in the way, the engine cannot slide into those frame rails. It would be impossible. We got the lights up here. We've got the exhaust and this little tank that will sit on the fender when we're all done. These are all glued together. This tree will get painted, then cut into pieces and painted separately as I go. We've got the flywheel cover assembled. This will not go in until we have the cab attached, and then it goes in from the bottom to seal around the engine. That's two pieces that go together. The hood is ready to go on. The hood does have a hinge that should interlock into the radiator, except you'd have to assemble it all now and get those pieces together. What I will do is I will clip right in the center of the hinge and then just snap it into place, and then we'll have our should be a working hood. So that's where we are for that. The engine slides into the front of the frame, and this is what you have, that little four banger, or not little, but good size four banger, exhaust, intake. All of this, according to pictures that I looked at, of the one I'm going to copy from online, was an off black color. So I will be painting it and then doing some dry brush. But otherwise, that is as it is, pretty much the way it goes right there. It's a nice model. We've even got our little plugs up here that we can accentuate when we're done. Everything fit together very well. The fits on this kit are absolutely fine, not having any issues with them, even though it is older. It looks like they either tested the molds and assembled it, or it was just in that good a condition. The cab I have in multiple pieces so that I can attach it to the frame and paint it and detail some of the interior as I go. We will attempt to lift off the cab and the radiator. I'm not going to put the windshield in, at least I don't think I am. At this point, I like it open like the box top. This is how I see most of them without a windshield in them. They're not really high speed. So even in cold winter, there's no doors. It wouldn't make much of a difference. The cab is in multiple pieces. You've got your radiator, the top of the radiator, the firewall, the dashboard, the two sides, the roof, and the back to assemble this cab, and we did that all on camera. Then I laid the back in to make sure that I had everything perfectly squared up, which as you can see is. I can attach that later, and then I can get in here and do the two little mini gauges and attach the steering and the steering wheel when I get towards the end. And a couple drops of super glue will hold that in. It's such a perfect fit. So the cab does line itself up easily. My suggestion is build the radiator, then attach your dashboard, then attach the cab sides, which will angle themselves out automatically. I laid some super glue in there to hold it tight. Then I put the roof into place. There's little pins, and then I model glued it together. Then I laid some super glue in there as well. And now we have a super strong assembly, which will accept the back when we go to assemble it. And then all of that will slide over the floorboards and go right down on. And I probably won't even need any glue to attach it. Then we've got the floorboards and the fenders. This part should not be here when we're done, but I'll use it to hold it and paint it. We've got our seat bottom, our floorboards. The floorboards are black. It will be easy to paint that by hand when we're done. I've got the pedals in place and our fenders all glued together. Obviously, I haven't attached the seat because I want to do that in a fabric or leatherette material. So that's as simple as that is right there. Now we've got our frame, the large final piece. Everything according to what I looked at, the transmission, all the linkages, the steering, the springs, the whole thing was painted one color by Mack. Every restoration I looked at was like that. If you want to build yours different, cool. I'm not saying I have the right answer on everything. We've even got these beautiful little hooks attached. Our front axle, our steering is all attached. We've got our, I think, the brake lever running back, or the gear shift running back to the transmission. We got our brake levers down here. Our brake levers come to a union and then back. We've got our chain drive, our gears. All of this was painted the same color as the chassis. And then I will paint the chain separately as if it's black and greasy when we're towards the end. But since this was all one color, I can get it all painted one color. You can see the beautiful linkages in there. And everything, hooks front and rear, rear light on there. Nice looking chassis, and it sits perfectly square, allowing me to casually mount up the parts. The fenders in this part all have holes they align to. Then the body drops on. All of that goes together so well. And the engine slides into the front of the frame rails. We'll line it up properly, and that just goes right back. I'll get it in there. Come on. It's hard to see black on black, and then that just lines up right there, and your engine is mounted. Then once that's in there, we can attach the front piece of that frame. So that's why I couldn't do that. And we have to put our drive shaft in and our flywheel guard. So that front piece of the frame will get painted up the same as the rest of the frame and then attached at a later point. So you can see how that engine will go in there with our drive shaft. It's going to look awesome. And I can't wait to start painting it, which is what I'm going to do right now.
Thank you.
Well, the used Mack is looking pretty good. We've got it this far. I've just got to seal it up, do the final assembly. So I wanted, before I glued a little more stuff together, I wanted to show you where it sits so you can see in more detail everything before we get to the turntable. So we got the two lengths of chain. You'll have more than enough chain. Just fold the chain in half, cut one of the links with a pair of scissors or a snippers, and you will have more than enough chain to run around your logs. I made sure to rust that chain because I've never seen logging or trucker chain that didn't have surface rust all over it. So we'll take that off. That looks great with a little rust paint and some flat coat. You can detail it to your heart's content. It is real metal chain. And when we take the chains off, we have timber. I did the logs in different shades. Now, since these are giant, These are 3 foot wheels, 36 inch wheels, and the logs are the same size. So I'm guessing this is supposed to be either ponderosa or white pine trees. So my guess is that this is Pacific Northwest or upper Midwest where I'm from, because we had white pine trees back in the day that were this big. 3 foot trunks were extremely common. So what I did was, when looking at them in our local park, they have a grayish, lighter tone to the bark. It's not all dark and all that. So I did that grayish, lighter tone on the white pine, painted the insides a bright, because that stuff is almost white when they cut it. So I painted that inside like so. I didn't do it a yellow tone. White pine literally is white when you cut it. It's super, super bright. So the logs are ready. Now there are seams and stuff on there on the sides. They're hidden pretty well by the paint. On the ends, you can see them. I don't care about that. But to hide most of them, when you put the logs on the bed, just tilt the seams in. So you've got a seam on the bottom and a seam in the center. And then if you just take the least visible seam, like this one, you can barely tell it's there. Set it on the top, wrap your chains over it, and you're all set to go. So you hardly will see anything unless you're looking right at the ends of that. And if you wanted to sand that down and fill those seams in, that's totally cool. We've got our 2x4s, our planks, used as support across the bed. I bleached those way out like they're cut timbers, and then mussied them and scratched them and dirted them up. There are two timbers on here with little pins on the end. Those should go on the farthest ends, and that's where your chain can be glued to, is those little pins on the far end. So don't cut those off. Be careful you don't break them off. And then the three can go 1, 2, 3, and then the two on the ends right there, right where you have your seams of your boards. The log wedges, I did a little bit of a brown texture like they're being used all the time, and a little bit of black texture like they're being kicked in with the work boots all the time. Those will be put under the logs when we glue everything in place. The signs, I painted the signs black and then scuffed them up quite a bit. The emblems almost look a little faded to begin with, which is awesome. Those will go on the truck, and those I'm not going to beat up or anything. I think since they're still using the truck is a little beat up. The owner of Columbia Lumber Company is going to make sure his signs still look good, so everybody knows who's hauling those logs to market. We've got the headlights here, the side lights. We've got these nice little steps and this little tank here that have to go on the truck. Those will be glued on individually. So will this toolbox. That will be glued on. Towards the end, those will go like towards our running boards here and stuff like that. The little black steps go in those little holes right there. We've got our cab all faded, but not destroyed. I've got the steering in it. This steering box has to go down. I've got a piece of tape holding it on. The steering box has to go down and connect into the frame down here. So I left that on there, taped it in, put the steering wheel in, and that's what we'll see there. Got that nice little Mack emblem on the hood, and then faded and weather checked my paint. I didn't do any rust on this. 1926, so maybe we'll say this is like 1930s when this is a little beat up but still being used every single day. That this thing isn't going to have a lot of salt that's being used in the woods and the mud and stuff like that, washed off every once in a while to keep it clean. This is how it looks in spring after winter and all the water's melted off of it. So I didn't really rust this vehicle. It's thick steel on these, and I didn't rust anything yet. We got our nice bed here, which I weather checked and wore down and made gray and wood and some semi-gloss and then flat coat, so it's all mussed up. And then our rusty metal frame underneath, that was just bare metal made up by the logging company. I figure that would be a little rusted. The frame and everything was painted by Mack when they ordered it in their colors. So that would have arrived with paint. The members here to hold the flatbed, I think, when they got a hold of it, they would have made it themselves out in the wood. So that would have been bare black steel, and that would have got surface rust on it. That's why it's not crusty. It's just surface rust. And we've got our wood tone on there. So that's my story, and I'm sticking to it. We've got our leatherette seat here. And then I sprayed the paint ever so lightly so that it looked like their butts had worn that off to the darker leather tone and kind of rubbed it down. And then I did the wood floor, like in the photographs of the one I saw for sale, the fully restored one, and then scuffed it up like they're getting it dirty with their feet all the time, and grease, and then scuffed up the pedals and the brake lever and the shift lever, which line up beautifully. So you know you built everything straight when those shifters go right through and line up. That engine is in there, did a little dry brushing on it, highlighted the spark plugs on the top, did surface rust on the exhaust, ran our exhaust out the bottom. Everything is lined up so beautifully on this truck. Got our front bumper finally in, pushed the engine in, the drive shaft and everything lined up perfectly all the way through to the transmission and our drive lines. Then I did our chains in a greasy, grimy metallic because they're constantly getting oil thrown on them. And then our wheels all push in with the hubs. There's no issues with fitting that. Got our tail light in. And we are ready to go. So I've got to push the cab down over the top, line that up, glue our bed on, put our boards across the top, put our wedges in, our logs, get the headlights on this bad boy, get the side beams on the cab here, chain it down, put our toolboxes on and our signs, and I will be done and we'll be back for the final. Round and round it goes. I have completed my very first build of the 1926 Mack in one of its three configurations. Atlantis has issued it as the log hauler first. They've included real metal chain. They've made sure the molds are in great shape. I have absolutely nothing to warn you about on this model. It should, if you follow the directions and take your time, go together absolutely beautifully. I mean, honestly, I was a little intimidated by a multi-piece cab and all the stuff going on there. Not to worry. Look how that thing lines up. Look at that. I mean, and that's just pressed together. The cab is not glued to the fenders. The hood hinges on its own. Maybe, well, it's going to fall off the turntable. Yeah, it's going to knock off because I've got it just on the very tiptoe. That's how long the wheelbase is. I'll do some pictures of that hood on there, off there in the final. We've got the trees done up. I did them in a little bit of different tone, so it doesn't look like the exact same trees. The only thing you can see is the seams on the end because the lighting is so strong in the studio. But if you line up the other seams along the bottom and the top, you really can't see any others. We got those nice log wedges. We got the 2x4 planking to go across that beautiful wood bed. We got the side placards. If you don't want to put them on, you don't have to, but I like them on there. It gives a little bit of, and I did it up in the green and yellow because there is one on a website called bringatrailer.com. 1926 Mack, just like this, in a green and yellow. And I said, okay, everybody's going to be doing the red or a black one. I got to do the green and yellow just because I like that color concept for the Macks. And I'm just so excited for Atlantis to reissue the tanker truck. I got a color concept for that one. And I can't wait till all of them are out. I hope they have a plan to release them all because, guys, as Atlantis, I will build every single version of this. It is absolutely gorgeous. And they've done a great job. The molds line up. It looks wonderful. It's a big, awesome truck. I can't say enough about it. I usually don't fanboy about a kit this much, but I've never built one of these before, and this is stupendous. This kit is out right now. You don't have to wait for a pre-order. You don't have to wait for it to come into stock or me to post a link. Atlantis Toy and Hobby has this in stock. Model Roundup has this in stock. Your local hobby shop may even have it. If they do, get it. If you like big trucks, you're going to like this Big Mack. It is just the epitome of old-style lumber wagons. Literally, the chain drive looks so awesome back there. Even though it's in one piece, it still looks awesome. The wheels, the solid rubber tires, it's just so, so much fun. I can't wait. Remember that in the box, you've got a lot more decals. If you wanted to do a shiny new truck, you've got a lot more in there. If you wanted to put the pinstriping on yours and all that. But I'm going to save that for some other versions of this truck. This one I wanted to do a little weathered, just a little beat up, as if it's actually being used and left out in the sun during the summer and the winter when they're logging and running it and all that stuff. And I am so happy. So the next version, I'll probably put the windshield in and all that kind of stuff, all that fun stuff. and enjoy that version. But until then, grab the log truck, build it up, show me on the Facebook page what you did with yours. And until then, remember to smile, have fun. Remember, it's your model kit and you should be having fun with your hobby. Thanks for watching the workshop. We'll see you all at the next review.